Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Hope you guys don't get sick of me. I'm up here twice now. Thank you, Pastor Michael, for giving me the opportunity to speak. It's always a pleasure, and it's always an honor to be up here and just share what God has in His Word. As we get close to Christmas, I think these things become a lot more relevant, and they come. We can maybe fill him a little bit more. As Pastor Michael said, there's the advent of love, the advent of peace, the advent of joy. But I think that out of all these, the one that's a little bit more, well, at least for me, the one that's more clear, I think the act of Jesus coming to this world is the one that was based on love. And we're going to dive into that today. But before I do, the first thing that comes to my mind when I think about this, sorry, I'm having a little time trouble having my Bible stay. There you go. Is what is love, right? That is the biggest question, especially when we're speaking about the advent of love. And now I know most of you in this room are just a little bit older than me, so you guys have a lot more experience dealing with love and what, you know, as you guys have gone through your lives, I'm obviously still nourishing and learning. But sometimes I feel that our society confuses what love is, right? We use love with such almost everyday language that it loses the beauty behind it. We say, for example, I've heard so many people say, I love pizza, right? Or I love this show, or I love those shoes. And a lot of times using that word so much takes away from the power that is behind love. But do we really love those things? Do we really love pizza and we love those shoes with the meaning that love is? Right? We probably don't. And as we examine more what this word means and how powerful it is and how God showed us and gave us the greatest gift through love, we'll understand the differences. A lot of times we, especially here, right? We look at love and we see it in movies. It's a couple holding hands, walking down the beach, and it's a romantically lit dinner, or maybe it's two lovers giving each other presents on Valentine's Day, right? We see it everywhere. That's really what this world tries to push us, right? That love is these colors and these roses, and it's very glamorous, and it's la la la, singing and everything. But a lot of the times, when you really think about it, especially as we begin to see what's in God's Word, love isn't always that glamorous, right? And those of you who have experience know that a lot of times love is not as pretty as this world makes it seem. And when we look at when Jesus was born, it was a scenario that did not have these things. So we see this beautiful display here of Joseph and Mary and baby Jesus and the animals, and it looks very, very nice, right? We see it all across the stores, and it looks very beautiful. But when you look at what was actually going on during the time that Jesus was being born, or while Mary was impregnated with Jesus, it was a difficult time, especially for Joseph. I put myself in Joseph's shoes because he's a guy and I can relate more to him. So I could just imagine that I am going to get engaged with Mary. I love her, and all of a sudden, I find out she has a child that is not mine, right? First of all, I mean, I would have gone insane. I could just imagine how many nights Joseph was just up wondering, like, I thought Mary was a genuine person. I thought that she cared about me. I thought that, you know, we were going to make this work. Just imagine all that keeping him up at night, just the thoughts that he must have had. I know I would have gone crazy. I would have just been like, I'm sure his heart was broken. He was stressing out. And he's like, well, what am I going to do now? Right? He had a few options. He could report her to the religious leaders in that case, which it was obviously very obvious that that baby wasn't his. And, I mean, the law said that they would stone her to death, right? He could also leave her secretly, right, and spare her life and just cancel the engagement. And he could be with her. He could marry with her. But marrying, imagine yourself marrying with someone that you feel has betrayed you. Just it wouldn't be a good foundation for a marriage, right? I'm not married, but I know that's for sure would not work. And so the Bible talks that I can imagine after a restless night and after deciding what to do, Joseph said, you know what, I care about Mary, but this is just isn't going to work, so I'm going to leave her. And the Bible talks that Joseph had made his mind up, that he was going to cancel the engagement quietly, because it was just too much, right? It was just too much pain. And it was then that God spoke to him through a dream, right? And he said, Joseph, you're not going anywhere. You're going to stay right by Mary because the child that she's having is from the Holy Spirit, and he is a Savior. But even then, right, Joseph's love for Mary had to be very intense. Had to be genuine. Because Joseph was now going to not walk into a regular family, right? He was going to be part of something that was maybe going to be out of his comfort zone. He was going to have to obviously deal with the questions that people were going to ask, right? Oh, are you sure? Are you sure that's the Holy Spirit, Joseph? I don't know. She might. So imagine all this stress that Joseph was going through. But at the end of the day, Joseph was a righteous man. And he loved God, and he also did love Mary. So he made it work. And we see that it's not as glamorous, right? It's a little grungy. It's not so pretty. But this is the type of love that God had for us, and even more. Imagine the kind of love that God had to step out of his comfort zone, right? To leave his child for us here on earth. And this love is a love that I will never really understand. I don't think any of us will ever understand the magnitude of the love that God has for us. Jesus, when he was born and later crucified, a lot of times we see that maybe the blood and the abuse and the humiliation that Jesus took was not a love that, when we look, is glamorous at all. But that is real love. And real love is sacrifice. 1 Corinthians 13 talks about how love is patient, how love is kind, how love is not selfish. And this is the type of love that God had for us, that he'd give his only son, right? That's the verse that we all know, John 3:16, that he'd give his only son. A love so intense, right? A love so grandeur that he was willing to watch or let his son endure all the pain, all the suffering. Because he loved us more. And if you have your Bibles, I'd like you to open to Mark 12:30. Because there's something about this love that we are called to action. Mark 12:30 says, "And you must love the Lord your God with all your heart, all your soul, all your mind, and all your strength." And the second is equally important: love your neighbor as yourself. No other commandment is greater than these. And so we are called to action, right? We are called to love our neighbors. We are called to love those that sometimes aren't easy to love, right? Because it's easy to share love when someone is all smiles, and we talked about there's that glamorous love and everything is butterflies. But the love that God asks of us, it's not an easy love. It's a love that calls us to forgive those who have wronged us, right? That's a big one right there. You can stop right there. But it's a love that pushes us, just like Joseph, beyond sometimes what we don't want to do. I'm sure that Joseph, when he had the angel, it says there that he did, and he went and he did what God had asked him to. And I'm sure that it wasn't necessary, maybe at that moment with a smiling face, right? He woke up and he said, "Yes, I will marry her, God. I will do what you said." I'm sure that there was still a lot of turmoil in his heart, that there was still a lot of confusion, and I'm sure that a lot of us in here have dealt with that. I know a lot of you guys are married or have marriages, and I'm not married, but I'm the product of one. And I know that in marriage, there's moments where things just don't always connect. But through the marriage that I've seen in my parents, I've seen that just because things aren't functional or because things aren't pretty at that moment does not mean that there's not love. Love will find a way to take those flaws, to take those and make it work. And I think that as we come and think about what God, the gift that God gave us through the birth of his son, that love that is willing to work through it all is a love that we have to share with this world. Because I don't have to tell you, you can see it on the news. There is constant news of how our world is even more infiltrated with hate and restlessness and wars. And it is our job to be that love. It is our job to be that light to this world. Love God and love people. Those are the two things that I think we can walk away from this Advent. That we need to love God and love people. And understand that both of those situations or both of those things won't always be as easy as we'd like. There will be moments where our faith will be tested. There will be moments where we are just like, "God, you know what? I really don't want to do this. Or I don't want to forgive. Or I don't want to let this go. Or just let me hold on to this." But through love, there's trust. And love calls us to trust in God. To say, "You know what, God? I love you so much that I am willing to obey you, despite whatever I'm going through, despite whatever my will is." And it's sacrificing, right, as Jesus did in the end, and saying, "Let it not be my will, but yours." Now, to have one more thing I'd like to say, which just in 1 John 3:16, another famous verse, it says, "We know what real love is because Jesus gave up his life for us. So we also ought to give up our lives for our brothers and our sisters." So as we get ready to receive Christmas, and it's a moment where we go shopping, right? I know I was speaking to LaWanda. She said that people at the stores are going crazy, and it's a lot of chaos, right, to get the right deal, to get the right price. Let's not forget that we're celebrating that we were introduced to real love. Because before Jesus, we didn't really know what love was. Love is, to humans, something that's very selfish, right? It's about, what can you do for me? What can I do to make you or keep you happy so that in the end of the day, I can be satisfied? But Jesus taught us that it's not about that. It's about laying your life down for your brothers and your sisters. It's about loving unconditionally, as hard as that may be, right? We're not asking that you change this overnight. But it's about adapting that, grabbing that love and saying, I'm willing to work on it. And as Joseph said, all right, maybe I don't want to marry Mary, but you're asking me to, and I will, because I trust you. So remember those two things. Love God and love people. Amen. Thank you.